are going.
Animal Kingdom.
It's 6:45 a.m. and we are headed to Animal Kingdom this morning.
We did it. Our goal was 6:15.
At 6:45.
And that's why I said 6:15.
You know, he told me last week that you guys would be getting up on vacation this early.
You wouldn't believe us, would you?
I would have said you're crazy.
Welcome to
Made it. A little past the opening time, but we did make it. Big tree, isn't it?
That is Mickey and Minnie.
Perfect flyby by the birds.
What's one?
So this is the line for Avatar. What we think is the line, but we're in a line. We'll see how long it is.
So, we didn't make it on Flight of Passage. But, Navi River Ride, we actually spent $11 again to do the fast lightning lane because it was a 5-hour wait. And that's with us showing up early. But we weren't early enough, obviously, because 5 hours worth of people were in front of us and another hour behind us. So, Mr. Rob said buy it. So we're gonna go do the river ride. 5-minute ride, wait, and David can ride it unlike the other one. And I've been bad to wait 5 hours, and David can't even ride it. Did you like it though? Was it fun?
I'm
another ride.
You want to ride another ride? You gotta cover your mouth when you cough, bud.
Safari for a walk on 5 minutes. David is excited.
Yeah.
And we got a pineapple lupia. Lupia, I don't know how to say it, but the pineapple cream cheese thing in Pandora. So that was good. David is ready and excited.
Say hi.
Just taller.
You're just taller.
Now I can ride all the rides.
Oh wow.
Well, because of his unique appearance. Also unique though, because he's the only relative there is to a giraffe. Black and white bird down below us on the right is called a saddle-billed stork. Very unique bird, makes no vocalizations whatsoever. Saddle-billed stork communicate with each other by rattling their bills. There's two of them here, there's one up ahead. Now the male and the female saddle-billed stork look exactly alike. Less than 5,000 left in the world due to poaching. You're gonna look at him and say he's not, they don't swim well. They walk or they run on the bottom of the river. Hippo can hold its breath for up to 8 minutes. Pinkback pelicans on the island to the left.
Yeah.
Their backs are pink during the mating season. Fight with 2,000 pounds per square inch of bone crushing force.
Oh, look, right there. Oh, they're up there?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Oh boy, listen to this bridge. Now I know why there's a new weight limit.
Oh.
Just a few more feet.
Oh.
Yes.
Shoot.
Ooh, that was a close call back there.
Wow. Some crocodiles.
I remember this road. This road's going to take us to the Serengeti.
Oh.
That's what the local people call the vast grasslands of Central Africa. These cattle are not as heavy as you might think because they're not solid. They're honeycomb. The animal's blood flows through the pore. It helps keep the body cool.
Which giraffe?
All right, we're going to see them.
These giraffes are called Maasai giraffe. Different species. Two species look exactly alike except the sable antelope. Now that's the animal that's on the sign at the entrance. They have horns that arch back over their backs, and it's how they defend themselves against a predator that would jump on their back, like a lion.
Yeah, like that one.
Springbok, up ahead on the right side, beige back, white belly, dark stripe down the middle, only weighs 100 pounds, fully grown. Springbok can jump straight up in the air, 6 feet. That's why they're called springbok.
Did you wait for the giraffe?
White-bearded wildebeest right next to us here, the gray animal. Local people first saw them, thought they looked ferocious, called them wildebeest, Afrikaans word for wild beast. They're not ferocious animals. Monkeys over here on the left side, mandrill monkeys. Oh, there's the dominant male in the troop, brightly colored rump. They've all got a bright colored blue and red nose, gets brighter when they get excited.
Look at the baby monkey.
Wait a minute, road closed, the sign says. That's a shortcut we normally take. Oh, the bridge is gone. 2 weeks ago, there was a bridge here. Oh, boy. No shortcut for us. We're going to have to take the long way around. Ooh, that's going to add 2 or 3 days onto this trip.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
There's a bridge I haven't seen in a long time. Oh, it's in terrible shape, held together with cable.
Oh no.
This is not our lucky day when it comes to bridges.
Oh, this bridge.
Oh, Ooh, bridge sounds bad, looks worse. It will be our lucky day if we make it. Oh, front wheels are off. At least I'm safe.
Oh,
and so are you.
We're safe.
I don't believe it. Two damaged bridges, two close calls. We could have upgraded, recycled.
Is that water?
Yeah.
See Greater Flamingo coming up on the left. Greater Flamingo are the lightest colored pink of all the flamingo species. Now when the flamingos hatch, they're gray. And they would stay gray except their favorite food is brine shrimp. A brine shrimp contains beta carotene, and after flamingo eat the brine shrimp for a year and a half, maybe 2 years. Beta carotene will turn the flamingos pink.
Wait, look.
That water.
Yeah.
Oh no. Not again.
Not again. He's like, not again. More water.
Here's a mud pit. Mud pits on the savannah will attract the white rhinoceros. They wallow in the mud, just like their cousin.
See it?
Black rhino. We saw that black rhinoceros all by itself. That's because they are solitary during the daytime, as with the white rhinoceros. They're a more social, docile animal. White rhino live together on the savannah in small groups called a crash, being anywhere from 3 to 5 individuals in a crash. I don't know, you're sitting in the back row of this truck, you better hope those cheetah aren't hungry. Let's get out of here. Females in the pride. There's a female right there.
Look.
Wow. I mentioned cheetahs are daytime hunters. 0 to 60 in 3 seconds. They chase down their prey. Lions are nocturnal. They prefer to hunt after dark. Lions sneak up on their prey. Over here on the right, there's a species of antelope that's extinct in the wild.
The fun?
Yeah.
We're going to see more animals?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What animals did you see?
Lions.
Lions?
No.
What did you see? Do you remember?
See an elephant?
Rhinos? A bird? Giraffe?
Yeah. Go see some gorillas. Look, more monkeys.
Punch in the jaw. Saw a monkey? Here we go, David.
Yeah. Whee!
Oh, here we go.
Oh.
Look at his head on the ceiling.
Do you see the head moving in her lap? It's playing in the lap there. The little ball is in there. You said 5 months.
You see the baby in there? Let's go get closer. See the baby in there? He's down there.
That's a human.
Yeah.
Who's Dada?
Okay.
Hey.
Let's go, Dada.
Okay. Oh, shake it. Now we just get pop up in the mood. She's dancing, I said, now we just gotta get you in the mood.
Stop for a potty break. And then we've got a sausage, egg, and cheese biscuit and a Mickey pretzel with plastic cheese.
Yum. And David has to show off on camera with his pretzel in his mouth. Papa's enjoying himself too. Out with the old, in with the new. You ready to ride the train?
Yeah.
Me too.
Hope I don't get scared.
No lines on this one.
Let's go.
Here
we go. Choo choo. High five, yeah.
Let's go.
Yep, we're going.
Where are we?
Greetings, friends, and welcome aboard the Wildlife Express.
Ooh.
For a safe journey, remember to stay seated, keeping your hands, arms, feet, and legs inside the train. Sit all the way back against the bench, and please be sure to watch your children. Asante.
Bienvenidos a bordo del Wildlife Express. Para que tengan un viaje seguro, manténganse sentados con las manos, brazos, pies y piernas dentro del tren.
Siéntanse
pegados al respaldo de la banca.
We going?
Y por favor, vigilen a los niños. Gracias.
Oh.
The first one's on the first train over. That's awesome.
Are you happy? Rafiki.
There go Piki.
There go Piki.
Who's that, Dede?
It's a cow.
A cow.
For me.
Got
bit by it.
He wasn't ready. It's a cow.
Now where you gonna go? You go find a goat?
Yeah. Hi,
are you eating? Hi guys. Anybody can reach, you can pass. You can turn here, you can reach him.
Sorry.
Let's try to put this one. Don't, no, you can't go under. You can reach over. Say, come here.
Don't touch the tail. Wait, it's okay. We're going to touch his head. Come up. Oh, look. Here he comes.
Hey, guys.
Look, touch. No, go. Oh, it's okay. He's going to come back.
I think so. I'm not 100% sure.
It's okay.
Mm-hmm.
Pet him?
Say hi, Pascal. His name is Pascal. Yeah.
Hi! Did I meet you over here? Did you miss that everybody else is eating?
Uh-oh.
Oh, there you go. Go get him. Go get him. Go ahead. Go get him. Get him.
Is that good? Oh, he might come over.
Oh,
again. See the sheep? See the sheep? See the sheep?
Go get him, go get him, go get him, go get him, go get him.
Pet the back.
You gotta pet the back.
Go ahead.
Go pet him. Go pet him.
Here, I'll go help.
Sophie
Vinka. Oh, wow. He likes that.
Is he nice?
Yeah.
Diddy's turn.
That's a big pig, isn't he? I'll touch his face, okay? You like him? You'll pet him again? It's a nice pig.
It's a conservation station.
All right, we are
doing
sketch class.
As they teach you to draw
the animation experience. We're going to learn how to draw.
Inspired by animals living here at Disney's Animal Kingdom.
We have.
Please find a seat and get your pencils ready because the animation experience begins in just 5 minutes. Walt Disney himself understood the importance of spending time around animals, studying their behavior and personality.
So we got to understand a little bit about it. And Walt used to bring in live animals so that his animators could study the animals themselves, because they start this advantage.
Meet Bentley, a meerkat. Bentley's story began on the coldest night of the year, safe underground and warm in a nest where he was born.
A little parallel line to the top of our nose. I'm going to turn it around.
I just colored this.
You're in a theme park. This is like Everest. Okay, you get that anxiety? Just put your hands up and scream. All right, do we feel better? I hope so. All right, so anyway, you guys should have a meerkat on here.
My mom's here.
And the rest of your adventure here at Disney's Animal Kingdom.
So we just finished drawing Timon and we did a pretty good job. David fell asleep during it.
We got a good artist lesson.
Yeah. David's upset because he couldn't do it, but it's okay. He's only 3.
You did a good job though.
You did a good job.
No.
Is that what you did?
Yeah.
You were scribbling. That's okay.
Planet Watch. We are now beginning our return trip to the African town of Harambe. For your safety, please remain seated and keep your hands, arms, feet, and legs.
Comenzamos ahora nuestro viaje de regreso a la aldea africana de Harambe. Para su seguridad, permanezcan sentados con las manos, brazos, pies y piernas dentro del tren. Siéntense hasta atrás, pegados al respaldo de la banca. Y por favor, vigilen a los niños. Gracias.
Welcome aboard the Wildlife Express, with service from Rafiki's Planet Watch to the village of Harambe. Go well, and remember, preserving the magic of nature begins with you. Asante.
Was that cool, Dede? Water buffalo. Underneath of it, they'll poop on you. They're cool, aren't they? Wow, look at that one. It's a pretty one, isn't it? My work today.
We have made it back to Pandora. We went through the monkey trail, whatever.
The gorilla trail. And the tiger trail.
Yeah.
The gorilla trail is where we already went. But yeah, we went to the tiger trail.
It's so bright, I can't even see.
I don't know if we're filming ourselves.
We are, okay. David. Hold on, buddy.
We have to do this inside.
This is difficult. So now we're at Pandora. We did a mobile order, and the time frame is from 11:50 to 12:20. And it's like 11:40 now. So
45.
Okay, so we have to wait till the app says it's ready. Hopefully it'll be ready. See? David's very cranky. And we need to leave after we eat because he needs a nap. The end.
Got our bowls, chicken and beef with the potato hash. Papa got the same thing, some cheeseburger pods. We know we're gonna love it. Pop-up's first time eating it, so we'll see what he thinks.
We'll give it a shot.
All right. 2, 3.
So we just finished eating at Satula Canteen, and we got the bowl with the hash potatoes, and we got the creamy sauce, and we got chicken and beef, but next time I want to get double chicken because the chicken was way better than the beef, but it was still really good. And we got the cheeseburger pods, which you saw, and the sauce burger. What did you think of the food, David? What did you think? It was not good, he said.
David didn't like the cheeseburger pod.
And he didn't like the chips because they were too hot. We're tired now since we've been up since 6:45. I don't know. What time?
6?
Yeah, 6. A mile or 5:45?
So 6.
6, yeah. So we're going to head back. Desmond says 4.
Yeah, I'm tired.
Chicken was good?
Yeah. Better than the beef.
But you'll eat here again.
Yeah, I'll get something different next time.
So the plan now is the park is like super crowded right now, so I'm glad we did the 7 a.m. entrance because there's no way we would have done anything. I think the safari is like over an hour. Pandora is like, or the Flight of Passage, like 2.5 hours right now. So the walk-on that we did with the Navi River is now like 85 minutes. So we definitely wouldn't have been able to do anything if we slept it. So the plan now is to go back to our room, take a nap, get recharged, and then see what time it is. And then we're going to come back here for our lightning lane for Flight of Passage, which I think is at 6. And then go to Disney Springs after we finish out this park.
All right, as we said, we're going in the back for a nap. Because Day-Day needs a nap.
Mama needs a nap.
Mama needs a nap. Dada needs a nap. Pop-Pop wants a nap. And we like taking it easy this trip. That's why we did extra days. So we have to worry about doing the park and everything in the park that same day. We still have another day at Animal Kingdom, so we have to leave stuff to do. It's really crowded too, so. But let's just have good and fun afternoons to take easy. David's almost asleep, literally. Hopefully he doesn't fall asleep before we get back, but we're enjoying ourselves. Yes, yeah, fine. But yeah. So. Nap time. Sing it, babe.
We're on our way to Jumbo House. Yeah. On another bus.
Yeah.
Hey,
go.
You
excited? Yeah.
Where are we at?
We're at Jumbo House.
We're visiting Jumbo House and take a tour. And guess what? It's happening at home.
It's snowing.
It's gonna get like 19 degrees tonight. It'll get a 50s here actually, but this is the coldest day of the week. So, but
it's a good day to be a snowbird.
Yeah, Pop-Up said it's a great day to be a snowbird.
It's a great day to be a snowbird.
We're gonna throw in some footage of the snow at home here, which you can watch right now. All right, we're at the Jiko little gift shop.
Jumbo.
Jumbo, yeah. We're at the bus station, waiting for the bus to go back to Animal Kingdom. Where are we going? Animal Kingdom? We're in Animal Kingdom. You ready?
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, we're back. Mr. Rob's gonna ride Flight of Passage for the first time. Me and Mr. Rob riding the first ride. First time riding it. He gets to ride it twice because we're doing a rider swap. So, looking forward to his reaction.
How many times have you ridden it?
Maybe four times.
Oh.
Maybe four or five. I'll have to go back through the vlogs and count.
Great. Welcome to the Avatar program. Soon, you're going to have a chance to undertake an amazing Na'vi rite of passage, flying on the back of this powerful animal called an Ikran, or as we call it, a Banshee. You've all got them. But don't worry. Almost. Yes, got him. Now, let's find you your Avatar mansion.
Come back. David, come here.
Let's go.
You're about to experience a ceremony that's very special to the Na'vi, flying on the back of an Ikran.
All right, go and get in. Got off. Was the top ride?
Oh yeah. Number one. Yeah.
He's gonna get to ride it again too, so he gets to kind of see what he didn't see. Because we probably missed a lot, because a lot going on.
That was awesome.
I heard him saying, whoa! You feel it in your stomach?
Oh Banshee. No, it's alright.
Did you feel him breathing underneath of you?
Yeah, I could feel that.
That's pretty cool.
I can feel him farting on me.
Or were you farting on him? Alright, we're going to get Mandy. I'm going to go take care of David, and then Mr. Rob gets a ride one more time. So he's going to have two in the book today.
Yeah.
More than a lot of people.
Double trouble.
Yeah.
good.
Is it good? What did you get?
This.
What is it, a chocolate cake?
Chocolate
cake. Dad got the blueberry cheesecake. But Day Day says it's good. Approved. Yum. Disney Springs. It is currently 9 o'clock, 57 degrees, and everybody's tired, but more importantly, everybody is hungry. Hence why Disney Springs. And there's Day Day. Oh, he's asleep.
David's asleep. He told me, he said, I just want to go night-night. I said, okay. So I laid him back. I said, is this good? He said, yeah. And then he's literally out in 2 seconds after that.
Literally. Like, there's no joke. I mean, within us walking 100 feet to the elevator, he was passed out. So, Disney Springs. I would have gone and gotten the balloon.
All right, I'm at Berglund Road. Manny and Mr. Rob went to Deluxe Burger. And I got fish and chips, the gluten-free version, because we like that version better, because they make it with champagne instead of beer. The batter, that is. But gonna take it over to them and eat it there.
Deluxe burger.
All right, Mandy.
Eating our food. It was really good. And it's cold.
Yeah. Mine was good. Always is good. So best fish and chips on property. But champagne style. Do it by champagne, gluten-free style. It's the better way of doing it.
You got cold.
David.
we do have it on the other side as well. Yeah, and we do still have two slices of cake and bites as well, which are quarters of our cookies, hand dipped in chocolate.
Thank you.
We
tried.
See,
peanut butter.
A peanut butter.
And a cookies and cream. All right, we're leaving Disney Springs. We figured out the cards, got them transferred for ours, Dale and Susan's. And David is up and awake again.
He had a cookie
from Gideon's. Mandy said it is
the best cookie I've ever had.
Yeah, look, a Christmas tree's bud. Yeah.
Turn the heater on in the truck.
There you go. It's quite chilly tonight.
Is it chilly day day? Yeah. About a dead phone.
Huh?
About to have a dead phone.
We are back to Kadani Village, going up on the Rafiki elevator.
Rafiki.
P-O-O-P-O.
Yeah, it's 200 steps left in them. Just enough to get them back.
Yeah.
This was a lot. I'm in my 30s now, and...
Man, what's wrong with y'all?
It's just a lot.
Dad is still ready. No, I'm happy to be back, but...
I could rock to Chico right now if you wanted to.
But you are used to staying up. My bedtime's 9 o'clock. Dad's bedtime's about 7 p.m.
I've
been up since 4 a.m.
And Robbie's bedtime's about 1 a.m. on a typical night.
Yeah, and plus I had my nap in today. I was knocked out. The minute I hit that pillow.
Me and Dede's bedtime's about 9 o'clock.
Yeah.
We're in bed by now, right, Dede?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's our bedtime.
Yeah. Well, we're back. Tomorrow morning, we go to Hollywood Studios.
However, when it's time to wake up, I am up and at them. However, Robbie and Dede are still in bed, usually.
Yeah. I like my mornings. But we're going to Hollywood Studios tomorrow morning.
We are. Even though I don't want to get up early and do it, I feel like that's the only way we're going to get a ride anyway.
Yeah, it's crowded. So, all right, we will see you.
200% of our new goal.
We will see you in the morning.
It really says that. Yeah.